Here are 9 hurtful things parents tell teens, other than the biggie. Hand me your keys. You can't have the car for a week. Seriously, being a parent isn't easy, especially when your child reaches puberty. And adolescence is no walk in the park for teens either. That's why this can be a turbulent time for both parties involved. What can make the situation better and help you both come out with your relationship intact is if parents avoid saying the following things to their kids. Spoiler: what looks like a harmless compliment can actually do some real psychological damage in a teen. But first, be sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell to join us on the Bright Side. Now, here's the first thing not to say. Don't do that. You see, most teenagers are rebels at heart, so they'll do exactly what you ask them not to do just to prove a point. Child psychologist Dr. Ariel Kornblum confirms this. She explains that focusing on teaching your kids how to do something appropriately is way more effective in this situation than using restrictions and forbidding something. So, whenever your teenager proposes another crazy scheme to you, don't yell "no" right away. Just offer them another idea with a casual "and what about this?" This way, they won't have any obvious reason to rebel. Plus, they may actually change their mind after seeing other exciting opportunities in front of them. Number 2. As long as you live under my roof, you'll follow my rules. When you live with a teenager, your house often turns into a battlefield with constant fights and screaming. Your child feels like you don't understand them, and you never will. So, what's the number one rebuttal among parents around the world? You live under my roof, and you'll follow my rules. Well, the first thing that'll go through a kid's head after this is, great, then how can I get out of here? During this period, they want to make their own decisions. So, if they can't live by their own rules at home, they'll try to figure out where they can. Dennis Boncher, an author and founder of the support group network Because I Love You, says that parents often use this empty threat to scare their children. But they have to be careful, because a teenager's rebellious nature can interpret this phrase as a direct guide to action. Number 3. Come on, don't be sad. Even when you're trying to show support for your teen who's feeling a little depressed or anxious, your phrasing can do more harm than good. This is a time when their hormones are doing all kinds of crazy things to their body and emotions. That's why you should be their safe haven, where they can come for support and understanding. And of course, your door is always open, the loving parent that you are. But according to parenting expert Cheryl Gould, by saying something like, "Don't be sad," you dismiss your kids' real feelings and teach them to suppress their emotions instead of working through them. So, whenever your teen feels depressed, ask them what's wrong and give them an opportunity to talk it through honestly without judging them. This will definitely tighten your bond and help you build a trusting relationship. Number 4. How could you do this to me? Whenever something bad happens, parents often ask their teens one question: how could you do that? And according to the experts, it's not the best thing you can say. Greg Chapman, a psychologist and clinical manager at Strategic Psychology, explains that teenagers rarely do something out of a sense of obligation to their parents. And that's why this argument will most likely not work on your child. Instead, they'll think that you're trying to make it about you when they're the one having a crisis. Chapman suggests that the best way to deal with the problem is to help your child truly understand the consequences and the impact their actions have on others. This will make your arguments valid and, therefore, make your teenager listen. Number 5. Find your passion. Well, there's nothing wrong with encouraging your children to find their niche in life. However, when said frequently, this innocent phrase can turn into a ticking time bomb. Jeff Lyken, a motivational expert and author of Adolescence Is Not a Disease, says that the pressure to find this one thing that they would love to do for the rest of their lives only makes teens more stressed and anxious of making the wrong choice. Don't forget that teenage years are for finding yourself and following your interests. So, teach your children not to be afraid to try new things, and one day they'll know exactly what their passion is. Number 6. You're getting kind of fat. Weight is a sensitive topic for pretty much everyone, especially teenagers. This is an extremely confusing time for your child, since their body is changing and they really don't understand what's happening. Almost every teenager becomes self-conscious during this time, and they certainly don't need any comments about their looks from others, you included. Nonetheless, a lot of parents think that comments like, "You're getting kind of fat," or "You've put on some weight," will inspire their kids to lose any extra pounds they might have. But what you're really doing is hurting them and making their self-esteem plummet to the ground. Dr. Kimber Shelton, a counselor and psychologist, says that this phrase provides no guidance whatsoever on how to correct one's weight. Your job as a parent is to be there for your child. So ask them questions and speak to them honestly. If they confess that they don't feel comfortable with their weight, provide them with information on how to change it and help them at every step of their journey. Number 7. You're so smart. Of course, complimenting your teen on a job well done is incredibly important. But you have to be careful here too. For example, constantly praising them for being so smart, talented, or pretty is a lot more harmful than you think. Dr. Timothy Gunn, a licensed clinical psychologist, says that these sorts of compliments put extra pressure on your child, making them afraid that if they do something wrong, you'll see that they're not so smart, talented, and pretty after all. As a result, they often avoid risky situations because of a fear of failure. On the other hand, the same praises can lead to a completely different outcome. A kid might start feeling entitled and forget that no matter how talented they are, hard work is crucial too. So, if you want to give your child some words of affirmation, use phrases like, "You worked so hard and figured it out. I'm really proud of the work you've done." Or, "I knew you could do it if you kept at it." This will make your teenager understand the true value of hard work and determination. Number 8. What's wrong with you? During a heated argument, this phrase may not seem that bad, but in reality, it cuts deeper than a knife. According to Dr. Carol McBride, a licensed marriage and family therapist, this phrase makes teens feel like you're pointing out that there's a certain defect you see in them. Basically, by asking this question, you're showing rejection and disappointment in them, something every child fears most. No matter what they did, never forget that you are their family, and there's nothing more hurtful than being misunderstood by your loved ones. So just speak honestly and directly about everything that's concerning you, making sure that they understand that it's their behavior you're bothered by, not them as a person. This method will help you meet each other halfway and keep your relationship open and trusting. Number 9. Why can't you be more like? If you want to find common ground with your teen, remember one thing: never ever compare them to somebody else. It just hurts and slowly but surely ruins your relationship with your child. Cheryl Gould says that this dangerous comparison game creates anger and people-pleasing in your teen. If you think it's a good motivator, just ask yourself, "Do I like it when others compare me to somebody else? Does it inspire me to be better?" The answer is probably no way. Then why are you doing this to your child and expecting it to work? Learn to appreciate your kids as they are, instead of desperately trying to change them into someone they're not. And if you want your teen to do something, just say it as is. There's no need to compare anybody here. Ah, words to live by. Do you know any other phrases parents should avoid? Tell us in the comment section below. Don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends and parents if you're a teen, and subscribe to stay on the bright side of life.